Recently, an ICT week, the second of its kind, was held at the African Union headquarters, comprising of various activities. A gathering held in connection with that deliberated on the viability of the sector in the continent's developmental aspiration. Speaking on the occasion, Dr. Ilham spoke about the significance of the week and how the ICT sector could contribute to the welfare of the population in Africa.
Through the ICT exhibition, the aforesaid thematic celebration provides a very good opportunity to showcase how ICT is a cross-cutting tool for all life aspects and how it can contribute to the welfare of the African community. Moreover, the sub-themes chosen for the conference sessions today will emphasize the role that ICT can play in promoting Africa's identity through projects initiated by the Commission.
The African Union, through the Department, is engaged in trying to facilitate the legal framework and other modalities so as to help countries utilize the most from the sector.
The Department of Infrastructure and Energy is working on strengthening the implementation and management of the various programs at the regional and continental level. Harmonization of the policies and the regulatory framework of the sector is gaining more momentum in the continent, and the Infrastructure and Energy Department is putting much effort in that direction.
The Internet has become an invaluable bridge for Africans to regroup and discuss social, political, cultural and economic issues facing them at home and abroad. But with the growing diffusion of Internet and mobile services, Africa is still said to be lagging behind, with digital divide within the continent itself very much visible, according to the governor liaison of DOT African Initiative.
It's actually developing and evolving at an extremely fast pace. We had lagged behind a lot, and that's not because we couldn't. It's because we had so many other challenges to deal with. We didn't have enough, infrastructure, affordable, accessible infrastructure. For example, our East Africa region was the last one to be connected to international fiber optic cables. Only, 3 years ago, we didn't have fiber optic cable at all in Kenya or in the East Africa region. On top of that, we have so many other policy issues to deal with: health, agricultural issues, famine, the usual African policy issues that actually take our focus away from engaging in the internet economy.
The governments of African states are seeking to put in place appropriate mechanisms for inclusive and expeditious development of telecommunication, ICT use, and their integration into all development plans and activities. But there should be much more commitment on the part of governments to realize the objective of the plan.
I think African governments have a major role to play. They need to ensure that they are creating an environment, a conducive environment, policy regulatory environment, to allow for innovation to grow, to allow for African youth to develop innovation, to ensure that education in colleges, in primary schools, starts and allows for our young people to actually grow up with the idea that you can actually develop applications, or you can actually work with the internet in a way that enhances your development economically, socially, or even politically.
With more services are accessed by the public in Africa from public offices, the intensification of the quality of services is indeed very much vital.
Many of our African citizens get a lot of services from the government. So having some of those services actually on the internet will encourage many Africans to begin to use the internet to access government services. And in that way, it will then compel most of us to begin to use the internet to get government services.
So we also showcased an exhibition